So going back to tables, you can change the first table. You can change the name to one of our tables. So we're going to have objects, creators, media, and roles. So you can make the first one objects. So just change name and then click change. And then the next one is creators. And then you click create. And then you have roles, create, and then media. So you should end up with four tables: objects, creators, roles, and media. We haven't created any fields or any records yet, so all of that is zero. And then if you go to relationships, you can actually see our tables are there. And then we're actually going to create our relationships. But first, we actually have to create the keys. So if you remember, we went over last class the concept of how we actually link our tables is via the primary keys, the primary key field. So we're going to create those right now. So if you go into fields, and you can see under table, there's a drop-down list of all of your tables. So you can always change which table you're adding fields into. I'm going to start with objects. So if you change your table to objects. And if you remember, all of our parent tables are objects and creators. The child tables are roles and media. So we're going to start with parent tables first. So objects is the parent table, and we're going to create a primary key field. So where it says field name, I'm going to do an underscore, underscore, key, K. Object ID. You can really call this field anything, but it just helps us to know what this field is, what it's storing, if we actually name it PK Object ID, so we know it's actually primary key. And you use the underscore so that it always shows up at the top, because it's always alphabetically listed, all of the field names, so this just makes sure it's the first one that you always see. So you click create, and then you've created your first field. And remember, fields, you can always change them, so don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back, as long as you haven't added in a lot of data into a field. Because if you delete a field, once you've added in information, it deletes the data. And it will always ask you, it will warn you before you do that. So
because you take out a field, all of the data associated with that.
Yeah. So, but again, there's a warning box that comes up, so. Okay. And then we're going to have some options with this, because this is a really important field. We want to make sure that it's always validating and it's always incrementing every time you create a new record. So if you click options, we're going to select the auto enter tab. So, so on the very first section, you see this tab here, auto-enter. It says automatically enter the following data into this field, and we want it on creation. So every time you create a record in this table, it's going to give it, we don't want a date, we actually want, I'm not sure. Validation tab. So if you go back to the top and click validation, always to be a unique value. So we always want it to be, we don't want the same number. This field is always unique. So you're going to say choir, click unique value in the middle. And then we don't want users to override this. So we don't want people to edit this field. So you uncheck allow users to override during the edit. Validation and uncheck allow user to override. So this just makes sure that you don't accidentally introduce a mistake into this field and change the number or add in any different information. And then click OK. And there you go. So now we've created our parent keys or primary keys for our parent tables. And now we're going to create the corresponding foreign keys in our child table. So if you go to the roles table, we're going to create two fields in the roles table. One is for the objects and one is for the creators. So you would do underscore, underscore, and then FK, so for foreign key, object. Roles table. And then click create. And that's it. You don't have to do anything else with this field because we're just going to be linking it to our parent key. So you don't have to have any kind of special validation or anything else. So then we're going to create another field, FK creator ID, in the same table. Roles however you want, but to link them. So you're going to actually select the primary key field in the objects table, and you're actually going to drag it to the foreign key field in the role, foreign key object ID in the roles table. So remember, we're just matching up primary keys to their equivalent foreign keys. So primary key object ID will match up to foreign key object ID. And then that's it. So you just drag it until it highlights the field, and then let go, and it will create the relationship for you. Same thing with creators. So if you select the field in creators and hold down the key, hold down the button and drag it to the foreign key creator ID in roles, let it go, and then it will create the relationship for you. The relationships between those tables. So if you think about it, an object can have many creators, it can have many roles associated with its creators. So that's a one-to-many relationship, one object for many creators, with many creators. And the same thing with creators. So one creator can be responsible for many objects, can create many objects. So it's a one-to-many relationship. This will become clearer as you're creating your records, and you'll see how they actually link up and relate to each other. So the last one we have here is the media table. So again, if you think about the relationships, an object record can have many images associated with it. So that's a one object to many media records. But one media record cannot be in many object records, right? It's basically only one object. So that's it's not a many to